Sometimes less is more. Do you really need all the gimmicky features that come in your gadgets? Take for example these Bose QC45 Bluetooth wireless noise cancelling headphones. So I have been using these headphones for the last 1 year, and in today's video, I will make a case as to why these headphones are better than their competition. Basically, there are three key players when it comes to over-the-ear Bluetooth wireless noise cancelling headphones: Sony, Apple, and Bose. Now, if you are an Apple fanboy, then the AirPods Max is an obvious choice for you. Priced at $550, it's perfect for you Apple fanboys who are either too rich or too stupid to care about money. But for the rest of us, it's Bose QC45 versus the Sony WH-1000XM4. That's a really stupid name, by the way, Sony. So these Bose QC45 headphones, they are currently going for around $279. But if you are a savvy online shopper, you can snatch these headphones for as low as $200 during Thanksgiving, Amazon Prime Day, or other occasional sales event. The Sony WH-1000XM4, it also goes for almost the same price as the Bose QC45. So why do I prefer these Bose QC45 over Sony? Well, there are three main reasons why these headphones are better than Sony. So the first reason is the noise cancellation. Now, this is a subjective opinion, obviously, but I find that the Bose QC45 does a far better job in eliminating distracting background noise than the Sony headphones, especially in the mid-range noise, like when people are talking in the background. So if you work in a noisy office environment and if you have a bunch of extremely loud colleagues, then these Sony QC45 headphones are going to be perfect for you. They also do a great job in eliminating static background noise. So for example, the noise coming from your air conditioner or refrigerator or even your noisy PC. Now both Sony and Bose will allow you to fiddle with their noise cancelling algorithm via their mobile app. But honestly, I don't have the time or the patience to mess around with that. All I want is a switch that I can toggle and eliminate all the background distracting noise. And in that regard, I find the Bose QC45 to be almost perfect. So this summer, I did a bunch of traveling with my Bose QC45, and these headphones, these were a lifesaver. So my domestic flight from the West Coast to the East Coast, it was jam-packed. And there were a bunch of little toddlers. They were screaming at the top of their lungs. I cannot imagine how I would have survived that long flight without these headphones. So all I did was I toggled the noise cancelling switch, and my Bose QC5 headphones, they were able to cancel out all the distracting noise in the flight, and I was able to keep my sanity. Now the second reason why I prefer Bose QC45 over Sony is because of its simplicity. While some folks may argue that Sony headphones are more advanced because they support fancy gesture features, but I'm not a fan of these gestures. The last thing I want when I'm wearing these headphones is to be swiping my finger up and down like a moron. I don't like doing that. And the honest truth is that these gestures are unreliable and they seldom work. So instead, I prefer physical tactile buttons on my headphones. So I've got a volume up and down button, I've got a hold and pause button, and then I've got a physical button for the, you know, noise cancelling. So I like tactile switches. I don't like these gestures. I hate it when companies replace simple tactile buttons with stupid touch gestures. Take the example of a Tesla car. Do you really need a touchscreen to operate your car? What's next? Replace the steering wheel with a touch sensitive slider? I think Elon Musk might just do that. The guy is a complete moron. And finally, the third reason why I love QC45 is that it's extremely comfortable. I can wear this headphone for hours without feeling any discomfort. Bose has picked the right material in constructing these headphones. Unlike Apple, who is obsessed with stainless steel and anodized aluminum, thereby making AirPods Max too heavy, Bose QC45 feels just right. It feels premium, yet comfortable and light at the same time. Now the Sony headphones are also quite comfortable, but for me personally, Bose feels much better. In my opinion, companies like Apple need to learn something from Bose. You don't always need to use premium material to make your products look fancy. For example, the iPhone Pro Max, it feels like a goddamn brick. Apple can easily shave off at least 30% of its weight without degrading the build quality. But no, they want everything to be made from stainless steel and anodized aluminum. Weight can go to hell, they don't care. And that's the reason why AirPod Max feels like, you know, wearing a steel helmet. Now, when it comes to sound quality, both Bose and Sony headphones are great. I mostly use these headphones for watching movies and videos and occasionally listening to podcasts. Since I don't listen to music that much, I can't really comment on the intricacies of their sound reproduction quality. And there are many other YouTubers who have made videos and you can watch those videos. I saw a few videos where people did like a detailed comparison of the sound quality between these headphones. So you can always go and watch those videos if you are an audiophile. But not everything is perfect with the Bose QC45. Their mobile app, honestly, it looks like trash. It cannot even follow the orientation of my phone and it always forces the portrait mode. And this is really annoying if I'm using my tablet. I think Bose should hire a few software engineers and make their app a little more polished. So let me know in the comment section below which over-the-ear Bluetooth wireless noise-canceling headphone would you pick. Also, do check the links that I've put in the video description below. These links will offer you the best price on this Bose QC45 headphone, and I keep updating these links so you will get the best price all the year round, including the holiday shopping season. Next, watch this video over here, and I will see you guys over there. Bye.